Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org. Storing the creation timestamp, or the timestamp of the last update, is a common requirement for modern applications. It sounds like a simple requirement, but for a huge application, you don't want to set a new update timestamp in every use case that changes the entity. You need a simple, fail-safe solution that automatically updates the timestamp for each and every change. As so often, there are multiple ways to achieve that. You can use a database update trigger that performs the change on a database level. Most DBAs will suggest this approach because it's easy to implement on a database level. But Hibernate needs to perform an additional query to retrieve the generated values from the database. You can use an entity lifecycle event to update the timestamp attribute of the entity before Hibernate performs the update. Or you can use an additional framework, like Hibernate Inverse, to write an audit log and get the update timestamp from there. And you can also use the Hibernate-specific creation timestamp and update timestamp annotations and let Hibernate trigger the required updates. It's obvious that the last option is the easiest one to implement if you can use Hibernate-specific features. So let's have a more detailed look at it. Hibernate's creation timestamp and update timestamp annotations make it easy to track the timestamp of the creation and last update of an entity. When a new entity gets persisted, Hibernate gets the current timestamp from the JVM and sets it as the value of the attribute annotated with creation timestamp. After that, Hibernate will not change the value of this attribute. The value of the attribute annotated with update timestamp gets changed in a similar way with every SQL update statement. Hibernate gets the current timestamp from the JVM and sets it as the update timestamp on the SQL update statement. You can use the creation timestamp and update timestamp annotations with the attribute types listed on this slide. Please be aware that the support for local date and local daytime was added in Hibernate version 5.2.3, so you can't use it with older Hibernate versions. Okay, enough theory. Let's get into the IDE and give it a try. Here you can see an entity that uses the two annotations to store the timestamp of its creation and last update. I just added the creation timestamp annotation to the createDateTime attribute and the updateTimestamp annotation to the updateDateTime attribute. That's all you have to do. When you now persist a new my entity, like I do in this test case, Hibernate gets the current timestamp from the VM and stores it as the creation and update timestamp. As you can see in the log output, Hibernate gets a new timestamp for each attribute. The creation and update timestamp will therefore not be the same, even if the entity was never updated. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video and an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate 5. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you like today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!